This is JC, Amber, Kristen, Aniston, JC, and Gemma.
Imagine getting a call that your child has been in a car accident, but what caused it? You go ask the officer if your child was driving bad or there was something wrong with the car. He tells you that another driver hit your child's car because they were under the influence of marijuana. The other driver is okay, but they take your child to the nearest major hospital. But imagine being under the influence of marijuana and they have no punishment for what they did because the law allows it. That is why I am here today to persuade you that legalizing drugs can have a negative impact on the United States. My knowledge of this topic comes from many weeks of research and from scholarly articles and government websites. To cover you on topics of legalization will impact the rate of drug users and addicts, targeting children and adolescents, and the crime rate. First, let's take a look on how legalizing drugs will increase the numbers of users and addicts. After Washington, Colorado legalized recreational drug use, Wynn, Hockenberry, and Cummings conducted a study. According to the study, there was an increase in marijuana use and addiction in those 21 and older as a result of legalization. It also showed a 17% increase in the number of days each month that marijuana was used. The drugs would be readily available for first-time users. Without stigma of marijuana being illegal, more people are willing to try it. Marijuana production is not monitored, like medicine that you receive from your pharmacy. Wilkinson points out in the article in Missouri Medicine that many marijuana growers breed their plants to alter the concentration of the chemical compounds. This leads to a higher level of THC, leading to addiction and other side effects. Data shows that 10% of people using marijuana leads to addicts. The Mayo Clinic explains that more heavy drug amounts can lead to getting high. Then they start examining more harsh drugs like marijuana, like heroin and cocaine. Let's look at a real-world survivor of drug addiction. This woman is a government worker, a mother, a wife, and very involved with the community. She got interviewed by CBS talking about her story. She admits that she was a teenager and started using drugs throughout her 20s. For 10 years, she stopped doing it, and then when she went out with her friends one day, she tried it again and was hooked. Since it was legal, she kept telling herself it was okay. Drug legalization across the United States can lead to more stories like this. Now that I've shown you how drug legalization can increase the number of users and addicts, let's explore how children and adolescents will be affected by readily availability drugs. Drug legalization would increase the availability of marijuana to adolescents because older siblings and even parents won't hide it. In the article, Implications of Marijuana Legalization for Adolescent Substance Abuse, Christian Hopfer states, there will be an increase in adolescents use due to increased availability, greater social acceptances, and possibly lower prices. The more that they use the drugs, the more often they will use. With the increased use, the health of adolescents comes into question. Madeline H. Meyer of the Department of Psychology and Neuroscience states that there is indeed an independent relationship between loss of intelligence and adolescent marijuana use. A study by Maya followed a subject that was 38 years old. The data showed that those people who started using drugs as an adolescent showed cognitive impairment. Now that I've shown you how drug legalization would affect the number of people and the effect on adolescents, now let's look at the impact drug legalization would have on crime rate. Legalization would decrease the crime rate of possession and distribution charges. However, according to Wu Nguyen and Wilson in the Journal of Criminal Justice, a study showed that in the state of Oregon, where recreational marijuana is legal, there was an increase in serious crimes, including violent crime, property crime, robbery, aggravated assault, larceny, motor vehicle theft, and burglary. Some will spend money on drugs and then that they can't afford. This leads to stealing and other crimes. The drug interferes with people's ability to focus and see how far away they are from other objects. According to Wilkinson in his article in the Journal of Missouri Medicine, a study showed in motor vehicle accidents where the driver was killed, recent marijuana was detected in 12% of this case. In closing, it is my hope that based on the evidence I have provided for you regarding the number of drug users and addictions, the impact of adolescents and drug-related crimes, I have persuaded you that drug legalization can have a negative impact on the United States, and also that drug use should continue to be illegal.
This is JC, Amber, Kristen, Aniston, JC, and Gemma.